Hello everyone, welcome to SemiConTalk. Today's topic is SiP. SiP is one of big buzzwords nowadays, so probably you already heard about that. SiP stands for System in Package. It includes bare dies, vaporable CSPs, packages, and passives. And it looks like this. SiP is used for smartphone, wearables, and IoT module. For devices, it is used for RF front-end, power amplifier module, and Wi-Fi and Bluetooth module. If you look at board of Apple iPhone 12 smartphone, there are several packages with silver-gray color. It is commercial. Typically, those packages are SiPs. You also can find this SiP package in Samsung Galaxy 20 smartphone. This is an example about RF front-end module to understand what kinds of devices in SiP and how it looks like. As you can see in the portal, there are a lot of bare dies and passive component, and also there are vaporable CSP packages. These are another example. You can see some dies with wire bonding and passive component and vaporable CSPs. Nowadays, more vaporable CSP package is used in SiP. So you can easily find out those packages in SiP. This one is a little bit different cases. Typically, SiP use package substrate, but this case use the pawn board for SiP module. Inside of S6 module, there are many other packages and dies and passive component. It is good approach to compare SiP with SoC to explain better. As you can see, SiP integrate a lot of packages and dies and passive component. But SoC integrate every function in one die. So SoC can maximize function within small area, but it takes a lot of time to develop, like more than 2 years. And also it has a lot of limitation to integrate different technologies and different devices or generations as well. That is the big reason people start to use SiP more. Then what is the advantage of SiP? Number one, size reduction. If you use discrete packages and dies and passive component, the system size will be much bigger than SiP. Number two, faster time to market. As I mentioned before, SoC need around 2 years to develop, but SiP only need around 6 months. Number three, it can integrate different technologies and device generation. SiP can integrate the silicon die and gallium arsenide die and others as well. In summary, SiP is used smartphone, wearable, and IoT. The key technology of SiP is SMT, surface mount technology. By attaching component and dies and packages more closely, it can reduce the package size. Its biggest advantage is size reduction, time to market, and integration. Thanks for watching, and I will come back with more episodes. Have a nice day. See you again soon. Bye-bye.